Welcome to mytubeguru.com. In the previous lecture, I have told you the basics of a C program. In this lecture, I will let you know about variables. A variable is a named memory location, and all the temporary data is stored in a variable. Variables are stored in main memory, and variable name is used for accessing the value of the variable. Each and every variable is mapped to a location of the memory called its address, and addresses of all the variables is unique. Here we will discuss basic data types, namely integer, float and character. All integers can store only numbers like 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, 3, 4, 10, minus 10, 1100, up to a certain range. And float can store values with fractional part up to a certain limit. Character can store symbols like a, at the rate. It can store only a single character. Now let us see the integer in detail. First emphasize on the size of integer. Size of integer depends on the machine that we are using. If it is a 16-bit machine, then the size will be 2 byte. If it is 32-bit, then the size will be 4 byte respectively. And if the size of integer is depending on the computer, then the range of integer is also depending on the size of integer. It can be calculated using the formula that is given here, that is 2 key power total bit minus 1 for positive values. Here I am writing this minus 1 for signed bit, because this integer is signed integer. It can store positive values as well as minus values, and this 1 bit is used to store the signed bit. And here this minus 1 is written for, because 0 comes on positive side in number scale, and for negative it is total bit minus 1. So for 16, if I am taking the 16 bit architecture, then it will be 2 key power 15 minus 1, that is 32,668, minus 1 will become 32,767, and negative values will be this. The size of float also depends on the computer. Respectively, if I am using 32-bit or 64-bit machine, then it will be 16-bit or 32-bit respectively, and range can be calculated using the same formula that we have discussed for integers. Here character. The size of character also depends on compiler. Normally it would be 8-bit if it is using ASCII code, or 16-bit if it is using Unicode. Normally in the case of Turbo compiler, it is 8-bit, and it can be calculated using the same formula that has been discussed for float and integer. Now let's see the type of variables. Here type of variables mean what type of variable we want to use. For that we will use the syntax data type, as we have discussed, integer, character, float, and name of variable that we want to assign. And we can give more than one variable name separating by a comma. Let's for example see, we can write int a, or we can write int dcd. Likewise, so let's take an example and elaborate it. If I am writing int a, then if I am writing int a, it simply means I am instructing the compiler that I want to create a memory location named a, having 2 byte size, where I can store an integer type value. For that, Compiler will create a memory location named A with the size 2 bytes for 16 bit. Here you can see it. If there is any value on the memory location, then that will be assigned to the variable. This value is known as garbage value. It simply means if you are creating the memory at any place, it may be quite possible that there is some value already on that memory location, then that value is known as the garbage value and we need to collect it. Let's see a very simple example. Here I am going to add a w.h. So here I will take two numbers as an input from the user. To the first number, address of A, and likewise to the second number, likewise scanner, function D, address of B, C is equal to A plus B. Now I will printf, let's see, sum of function D and percent D is equal to percent D comma A comma B comma C and some back. Let's save it somewhere. Same as I have told you, the extension of the C program will be dot C. Let's say second. C, let's execute it, compile and run. There is no error. First number 2, number 3, sum of 2 and 3 is equal to 5. So let's discuss this program. As I have already told you in the previous example, what this line is doing here, what main is doing here, for what these curly braces stands, and as we have discussed in this, what does int ABC are doing here. And here let's discuss the scanf. The scanf is a function that is used to take the input from the keyboard and write the values in the variables that we have created here, that is A. So that's why what I have written is that I want to take a value from the keyboard of integer type. Here percent indicates that the value is of integer type, and I want to store it on the address of A, the memory location that has been assigned to A. Similarly, we are doing the same here. We are storing a value of integer type on the address of B. And here what I am doing is that I am writing this %d% %d with ABC. It is here it is 1-to-1 matching for this D for A, this D for B and this D for C. And this %d is being replaced by the corresponding value of the variables. That's it for this lecture. Thanks for watching. Thank you.